Well, to shed more light on President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi's visit to Iraq to attend a tripartite summit, we have the pleasure to have this phone with Dr. Ashraf Singer, Professor of International Relations. Good afternoon, Dr. Singer.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Singer, now after 30 years, the first Egyptian president, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, arrives in Baghdad to attend the tripartite summit that is gathering Egypt, Jordan, and Iraq. He arrives in an official visit. How do you see the importance of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi's visit after 30 years? No one of the Egyptian president have visited Iraq.
President Sisi and his visit to Iraq today reflect the Egypt vision that was established in 2019 when Egypt really made that initiative with Iraq and Jordan to build, like I would say, a new Sham or a new region of cooperation between Egypt and Iraq. And I think President Sisi on his visit today, after 30 years from that, I would say, not really a normal relationship, but since President Sisi took the office in Egypt, and one of his priorities to bring all the Arab countries back to the same line to build, I would say, the what that mean the Arab corporations and translate that cooperation in on the ground, and I'm very happy about this visit. We would say that visit reflects many messages to the Arab world and to the international, I would say, leaders who are really observing this visit in different way, supporting the bilateral trade between Iraq and Egypt and Jordan. Second, discuss the future agreement about the security and stability in the region. And actually, Iraq at that time needed really to put its hand with Egypt and Jordan for many reasons. You know, we need really to rebuild Iraq again to be one of the country that can really support Egypt and Jordan, and don't really let Iraq, you know, move away from the all the arrangements in the Middle East and in the Arab world. And I think one of the major achievements of this visit, it's really reflecting the will of Emirates, Saudi Arabia, and all the Gulf states that we need really to bring Iraq back. And by the way, also Iraq, arranged with a crucial visit or meeting between the Saudi officials and the Iranian officials, to can really build, I would say, the environment of cooperation in this region.
Yes. Dr. Singer, now with this tripartite meeting, also President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi on the sideline have held meetings with the president of the head of the Iraqi parliament, and he is holding talks with the high officials. Of course, he met with the President Burhan Saleh and Mustafa Kadhimi, the prime minister, of course, as we saw earlier this morning. So what do we expect from this tripartite summit? Do we expect a fruitful talks and taking in consideration the civilizations of Iraq and Egypt, two countries of great civilization? What's your comment?
This is kind of foundation, we would love, to to repeat it in every time, in terms of what, the history of Iraq, the old country in that region, Egypt. And the most important that both of Iraq and Egypt, plus Jordan, they agreed to stop the bloody groups that they were really interested in defeating Iraq, Jordan. I mean, here, you know, the Daesh, you know, that group, they were really interested, you know, to increase instability in this region, in Syria, Iraq, Jordan. So this kind of meeting between Jordan, Iraq, and Egypt and Iraq, or among all these leaders, you know, the most important that we need really to build, I would say, that kind of arrangement to bring all that countries together to stop this kind of terrorist group in Iraq, who really killed these guys. They were killed really, you know, many Iraqis, and Iraq, you know, was suffering many years since, you know, the day of where, you know, the United States invaded Iraq in 2003. But Iraq really at that time need really strong country like Egypt, and Egypt was a big heart and open its arms to bring Iraq back again, and big understanding of that different ethnicity and different, I would say, goals, either from the different group in Iraq, you know, and what is the most important of it to build that harmony among, you know, the local groups, and moving them being like a rivals groups in Iraq to be like a cooperative group. And I think this is one of the most of achievement that Egypt, you know, working hard in that file. I mean, the Iraq situation, and Libya situation, because we were sharing, I would say, the theme, like threats about the Arab national security, and particularly Egypt national security, and that kind of, you know, breaking through that kind of visit, that kind of situation by that visit. President Sisi gave a message that Iraq now is pretty secure, that Iraq can really open again its door for investment, and I think one of the Egypt's responsibility to help, you know, all the Arab countries, because Egypt think Iraq, Jordan, Yemen, Saudi Arabia, Emirates, all the Arab countries really present the Egypt's interest or Egypt's goal about what is the definition of the Arab national security. And this is a good time to see President Sisi in Iraq. And I'm very happy as an Arab citizen, as an Egyptian too, to see that presence, you know, really occurred this morning.
Yes, so Dr. Singer, you were just mentioning the message that is conveying by the visit of President Abd al-Fattah al-Sisi, also with the visit of the King of Jordan, King Abdullah II. You were speaking right now about the message behind President Abd al-Fattah al-Sisi's visit. Do you think it's a message that Iraq would come back to the old role that it used to play in the region? In addition, yeah, of course, hand in hand with the big role Egypt plays in the region.
Yes, actually, this is a very clear message to the Arab country, all the leaders in the Arab countries, all the leaders in the international community. Yes. That is, Egypt as a big country can really handle the stop the ceasefire, you know, that kind of agreed to make that ceasefire between the Palestinians and Israelis. And now the second success since 2019, that Egypt really succeeded, you know, to bring Iraq back again. And this is very important message, you know, if you can think about, you know, what really the U.S. really failed in Iraq, and now currently in Afghanistan, they didn't really achieve what was the goal that we were expecting from, you know, the big country like United States. But they failed. Yes. But because of, you know, Egypt, you know, think that Iraq is like one of the brothers of the Egyptians and the Egypt country, and it is responsibility that Egypt should really give help to the Iraqi people and to the Iraqi government and reunion Iraq again, build Iraq again. And this is one of the major responsibilities of Egypt about their brothers in the Arab world. And Egypt cannot really be a big country without their brothers. And this is what was really the meaning of the Arab Union in terms of definition. And President Sisi, by his vision, he really translate that kind of paper or the ink on that paper to really translate it in real life on the ground, seeing, you know, that kind of action on the ground. And that visit is really one of these actions that we need to see or embrace it on the vision of President Sisi to see Iraq coming back again as a strong country, peaceful country, try to put hands with the Gulf states, try to remove all bad memories about all leaders in Iraq who made really bad mistakes or bad actions against Kuwait and the Gulf states. And I think this is time now to continue and understand the new threats come to the Arab world, and President Sisi seeing to build that kind of cooperation between among Iraq, Jordan, Egypt. This is one of the major diplomacy or success of the Egyptian diplomacy to bring all these guys together and can be like a new core of nice cooperation. You know, even Iraq president mentioned before that kind of you know, cooperation among Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, the new stone or the build a new stone in an Arab world, like, you know, the all the initiatives among the European countries where they succeeded in to achieve the full the EU you know, cooperation. And I think Arab worlds can really move after Egypt moving to Iraq and Jordan, and they can really follow this kind of, you know, the new initiatives. And I think that initiative will not really annoy any big countries in the globe, what yes. I mean the United States or other countries, because the United States needs really that kind of support, you know, really to recover, you know, their failure in Iraq before.
Yes, Dr. Singer, also, how would this tripartite summit solve the common challenges that, I mean, every country of the three countries meeting today in the summit has its own challenge. So how would this tripartite cooperation help in dealing with those challenges?
We understand the new challenges, you know, are and we're facing, you know, this country as terrorists, you know, a new challenge comes from threats from non-Arab countries. They have still some interest in Iraq and Syria. So Egypt, the one of the major countries in terms of the power, military power, population. So it's still one of the major balance with the other threats. So second, third, increase that bilateral trade and increase the volume of trade over time between Egypt and Iraq, Iraq and Jordan, Jordan and Egypt. So, you know, try to open like a big market, you know, among all these countries, and invite, of course, you know, the Gulf states. So this is can really increase stability and improve that level of trust among, you know, the Arab countries in different corners in the Middle East. So my best understanding, this summit, it's really crucial, it's really important, you know, to see all the
yes.
presidents.
Yes, I thank you very much for your time and for your valuable information, Dr. Ashraf Singer, the Professor of International Relations. Thank you very much for your valuable information. Well, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi on Saturday urged continuing taking the procedures that are required in order to maintain the stability of economic and monetary indicators. The details in the following report.
Egypt's President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi on Saturday urged continuing taking the procedures.